Welcome. Take your pick. This one. Thanks. Have a nice day. I'm bored.
Oh, welcome back. There's someone here to see you. Uncle Burroughs, this is the boy I was talking about.
Ah, about time. You're our dragon boy, then. The king filled me in. Call me Burroughs. How are you holding up?
Hi. It's, nice to meet you.
Oh, forgive me, Yuma. I should have mentioned. This is Burroughs, captain of the Knights of Astoria and an old family friend. Captain! If you're making a visit to the Seagull, that must mean you've got work for the Dragoneers, right?
Right you are, my lady. A hunting contract. Seems something big is out terrorizing folk beyond the walls.
What, a monster? More than your knights can handle if you're asking for a Dragoneer to deal with it.
Well, the Knights of Astoria... See, we've got our hands full with something else right now, so...
I see. By all means, then, let's petition the Dragoneers!
Hey, Sonia. There are other Dragoneers besides Kirika staying here, right?
Three of them, all told, yeah. Kirika and two others all use the Seagull Inn as their base of operations. And when the throne doesn't have official contracts to offer, they go around assisting the people of Marga instead. There's not a soul in Marga who can't tell you a story about a stout-hearted Dragoneer. You can always rely on them. Astoria owes generations of peace and comfort to their protection. By playing their harmonics, they can channel special magic and perform feats far beyond other people. All to keep the peace, of course.
Harmonics? Is that what you call those instrument weapon things Kirika and Excella were using?
Mm-hmm. Long ago, the shining dragon inside you gifted them to the ancients so they could protect themselves. There are supposedly seven harmonic armaments in all, three of which are here in Astoria. The elves of Welland have another three. And the last one's in the care of that imperial princess.
Welland? Oh, but isn't that Kirika's homeland? What's she doing fighting for Astoria instead?
Well, Astoria and Wellantine relations are peaceful. The elves' ancestors lived here a long time ago, so we've been allies for generations. At any rate, I should go and see about this something big. You stay here where it's safe, Yuma.
You're going all by yourself?
I can't just demand a Dragoneer's time without doing any scouting first, now can I? It's my duty to aid them in my father's place, you know.
Be that as it may, my lady. Maybe take Yuma with you all the same, just to be safe?
Me?
Don't worry, Captain Burroughs. It's just a scouting op. You don't have to be so protective. Emma, could you make Yuma some tea? I'll be back before it's cold.
Ah, my lady, wait! And she's gone. Emma, why didn't you stop her? Now I have to figure my plans out all over again.
Plans? What in the world are you talking about?
Nothing, yeah. I didn't say a thing. Now, how to fix this? Hey, Yuma! Little coward, are you letting the princess totter off into danger all on her own?
Huh? But she said she was just scouting, so...
No excuses. Get after her right now, boy. Hop to.
Wait, why? Why do I have to do this?
I'd do as he says, Your Radiance. Sir Burroughs is a very stubborn man. Arguing will only make him grumpier.
Fine, fine. I'll go. I'm going.
Allow me to accompany you, Your Radiance. If we hurry, we should be able to catch up before Sonia reaches the gates.
Yes!
Hi.
Yes!
Enemy approaching!
Is there no other way?
Healing
Let's go! Ha! There! Take this!
Spotted.
I shall fight.
Yeah. Ha. Ha.
We've been spotted!
All right.
Thank you.
Looks like the coast is clear.
Looks that way. Thank you, Yuma. You were a big help. Let's go report back to Burroughs now, huh?
There's no need to return to town. We can give our report right here, actually.
I've been made, eh?
Captain Burroughs, what are you doing here?
Begging your forgiveness, m'lady. Killing monsters wasn't the only thing you were doing out here. I wanted to see Yuma and the Shining Dragon in a real fight, you understand?
I see. That's why you were so adamant about this.
Yep. Figured a monster sighting was as good a chance as I was gonna get.
I suspected as much.
Captain Burroughs, don't you think that's extremely unfair to Yuma? You tell him too, Kirika, how it's an affront to the Shining Dragon's honor or something.
That may be so, but his radiance has blessed us with his sublime presence, his holy splendor. I knew of Sir Burroughs' plan, but said nothing, so that I might lay eyes on his radiance again. I'm not certain I have any place chastising the good captain for his actions.
Lay eyes on... Whatever. Fine. Fine. We'll talk about it later. Let's just head back to the castle for now, okay? And I'll be sure to mention it to my father. How bravely you fought alongside us, Yuma.
Yeah. We've been spotted! All right! We've been spotted! Let's go! Yeah.
My. Welcome back. Good night.
Yeah.
How's it going?
Yeah.
Welcome. Take your pick. This one? Thanks. Take your pick. Have a nice day.
Good day. Did you need something? Hello.
Acting on your own again, Burroughs. I don't know what I'm going to do with you, old friend.
Begging your pardon, Majesty. You know how it is. I just had to see the Shining Dragon's power for myself.
I understand Captain Burroughs' reasoning, and I don't think I'm gonna pass comment. Not right now, anyway. But I will say this. Yuma fought with us, and he fought as hard as anyone else. There's no need to doubt Yuma's strength. Don't you agree, Captain?
Is that so? Yes, Burroughs, let's have it. What's your assessment of Yuma's performance?
With all due respect, of course, I have to disagree with Milady. From where I was standing, it seemed to me the Shining Dragon was a weapon of last resort. He hesitated, flinched under pressure, Yuma, answer me. You're afraid of your power, aren't you?
Afraid? You may be right. The dragon's power does frighten me, since...
Since
I...
You've got your reasons, I suppose. But let me tell you, boy, until that changes, you're a liability, and you'll have a hard time fighting. And that's all I've got to say on the matter, Majesty.
Very well. I have no reason to doubt your assessment.
What? But Father!
That will be all, Sonia. I suggest you return to the Seagull Inn and take a well-deserved rest. Am I understood?
Yes, sir. If you'll excuse us.
The boy fears nothing more than the Shining Dragon, yet carries its soul within his breast. What a life that must be.
Not exactly your typical trials of boyhood, are they?
I trust you've seen the Gaelritz reports by now, about the Princess Excella and these Draco Machina of hers. Unless I've missed my guess, the Imperials are making ready to change the face of this war, Burroughs. With those Draco Machina running unchecked, the Shining Dragon may well be our last hope. We must have Yuma's aid. Everything rests on that boy's shoulders. Providence help him.
Hey, Sonia. Why did you talk me up like that to your dad? You made me sound like a way bigger deal than I actually am. Would he have gotten, mad? If you hadn't covered for me, I mean.
No, no, Father's not like that at all. And I wasn't covering for you. I was believing in you. I do believe in you. Deep down, you have a brave heart.
Huh? But I'm not brave at all.
Yes, you are. You didn't want to fight with us, right? You were scared, but you fought anyway. That's bravery. You can always be better than the person you were yesterday, Yuma. So please, believe in yourself.
Yeah.
How's it going? Hey!
Everyone, remain calm. Get the wounded indoors and into the back room.
Supplies, medical supplies. Do we have any bandages left?
Hey, what's going on? What happened?
A dragon attack, m'lady. It swooped down on us right outside the city walls.
A dragon? Could it be a Draco Machina?
No. I can't feel any of them nearby.
Kirika, you can sense that?
Yes, Your Radiance. All dragon souls emit an echo, a resonance. Divas Magica attune themselves to it so we might commune. If any exceptionally potent dragons are nearby, I should be able to feel them.
It's a live dragon, then? Not a Machina? I thought the greater dragons all died out 1,000 years ago.
Yes, the tales say as much, but they also say this, that long after a dragon's body and mind fade, the soul endures.
The dragons died out? And something about their souls? Wait, that sounds like...
Given the survival of his radiance, and the nature of the Machina, I wouldn't exactly discount the possibility of another living dragon.
We're gonna need eyes on it either way! Let's get out there!
Oh no! This is terrible!
Emma, are you okay?
Oh no, dear, it's just... Well, I hadn't seen Primula for a while, and I just found this note.
This? Let's see. Going to gather some ingredients back by sunset. Oh no.
She went outside the city walls before the dragon struck.
No! My baby girl!
We'll find her, Emma. Kirika, with me!
I'll go too. More eyes can only be a good thing, right?
I appreciate it, Yuma. Thank you. Now come on!